It is now all-out war over the nation's borders. The federal government is going to the High Court to force all states to reopen, arguing that the worst of COVID-19 is now behind us. Here's our political editor, Peter Van Onselen.
It's official. The Commonwealth has had enough. Prepared to legally challenge states keeping their borders closed.
There have now been relevant notices filed with the High Court, which indicate that the Commonwealth government will be intervening in the cases that argue that the border closures are not lawful or unconstitutional.
Section 92 of the Constitution says borders between states shall be absolutely free. That's the Commonwealth argument for why border closures are unconstitutional. Some states agree.
None of this makes sense to me. We are one nation.
Others, like WA and Queensland, do not.
That's because the Constitution allows the states to close borders on health grounds. The Commonwealth says that with the virus now under control, those powers are no more.
Our argument is that they are no longer lawful or constitutional.
Hence the High Court challenge.
Those decisions are going to be tested very soon in the courts.
With the Commonwealth joining Clive Palmer's challenge against WA's border closures.
And certainly we need to make sure that we get those border closures ended.
South Australia has just opened its borders, but only for some.
And I think it's crazy.
Well, look, I don't want to be offensive to South Australians, but why would you want to go there?
Now, I'd encourage everybody to come and visit South Australia.
South Australia and Tasmania want to create an interstate travel bubble with WA. But WA doesn't even want to open its borders to them, much less the coronavirus capitals of Sydney and Melbourne.
So much for unity at National Cabinet, much less the notion that...
And we're all in this together.
Today saw the biggest spike in cases in weeks coming out of Victoria as we wait to find out if the Black Lives Matter protests have sparked a second wave. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.